And that's it. We've finished creating our content provider. Since this has been an involved section, let's talk about what we created. We started off by defining the URIs that our content provider will support. We then updated our contract to reflect these URIs. From there, we built a URI matcher that matches these URIs to constants we use in switch statements and all of the other required content provider functions. Then we implemented the getType function to return the type of cursor returned for each URI. We then implemented the content provider query functions, followed by the write operations, insert, update, and delete. Finally, we talked about the optional bulk insert function to make updates to our database in a single transaction. This performs much faster and causes less wear and tear on the flash chip compared to updating the database in multiple transactions. There are lots of libraries out there in the Android open source world to help you build content providers. If you want to use them, you'll be able to use them now with the confidence that you know how they work and what they are doing. So, all queries and updates to the database can now be done through the content provider interface, but we're still not using it in our code. Let's fix that.